thing is, it's really heartwarming to see that, you know, sports has gained a lot of importance in India, which wasn't the case in the past. But then it's now very encouraging that, you know, schools are, you know, into a lot of sports education, and it's growing in India. But there's a lot more that needs to be done in terms of, you know, how systematically it could be done and, you know, more reachable to all kids. It's only a select few who, you know, have the access to sports and kind of formal sports education. And I think just as a similar to how we have, you know, a syllabus for academic education, it would be good to get a system of sports education that goes on parallelly in schools along with, you know, in the curriculum, which would be really good for children because there's so much that goes behind playing a sport, not just professionally, but through your career. If you have played a sport, there's so much that you learn. And that's something many people realize later in their life. They say that having played a sport benefits them so much. How to handle people socially, you know, social pressure. How do you go about talking to people? So there are a lot of things that which would play a big part, which you don't get, you know, just out of academic learning, you know. So it teaches you a lot more things, and you learn to face all sorts of scenarios, you know, victories, defeats, and you've got to take everything in the same stride, you know, humble in victory, and, you know, when you're defeated as well, you know, come back the next day, you know, just come back with all your courage and fight it out the next day. So definitely anywhere, you know, structure is important because when you do have certain goals, then there's a certain amount of discipline that comes within you to want to achieve those goals. You know, you start setting some targets, and it need not be necessarily very competitive, but, you know, it's just for each child to identify their potential. In sports education, it should be more about bringing out the best that you can, rather than, you know, wanting to compete with somebody else, because it is your physical talent, your skill, and each one of us, you know, it could be sport, it could be anything else, dance, music, whatever it may be, you know, you may excel and shine. So the important thing here is to give them a chance in a systematic manner, you know, in a formalized manner, because, you know, where they have somebody good to teach them, to instruct them, to guide them. I think they will all enjoy the same thing as well as learning. They will enjoy it, and you will see the progression. Definitely, because we're all having to improvise these days with the scenario that's going on. So I think even, you know, even academic education kind of is going online these days. You know, schools are taking classes online. And it is important to have, you know, your mind and body working together. You know, children all the time confined indoors and just, you know, playing with gadgets or taking these online classes is not a good thing, because, you know, they do need a certain amount of physical activity for everything to be in sync. So it would definitely be good to have, you know, as they have in their school, regular school hours, a PT period, you know, maybe a couple of times in a week, scheduled along with this online education, where they could get in, you know, maybe the physical education teachers or somebody who's been there, you know, and achieved and, you know, represented the state, the country, who's been through the journey, definitely has a lot to share from their experiences. Right. And it's hands-on learning, because they have walked that path, so they definitely know what it is. And most of the time, you know, in sports, most children get disheartened because they're not able to do something, you know, like, for instance, if I have to teach a child tennis and he or she is not able to hit that ball over the net after 1 week, you know, they get disheartened. But, you know, it's all about how you motivate them, how you teach them, how you talk about your experience of how many times I had to try to do that, you know, to get it right. You know, that's where the motivation, you know, that's developing the interest in the child. So that's important. Children pick up a lot when, you know, in these younger years at the grassroots level. Right. And you could also have so many of them who would not have an opportunity to, you know, play a sport other than maybe in school. It should be looked at maybe in an all India level, where sports education should become more formal.